Jordan, you're not working, so. All right, look up here and listen. Even if you're not finished, I want you to look. First of all, a negative and a positive, according to the chart, is going to give you two negatives. Two negatives means you're going to add. So what times what is 7? That's going to add to give you the middle one, which is 8. Well, the only thing that works is 1 and 7. You were taught to check your outer and your inner. So a negative 7 and a negative 1 gives you a negative 8. Now, the opposite of a negative 1 is a plus 1. The opposite of a negative 7 is a plus 7. These are called your solutions or zeros. That's where the quadratic equation or the parabola hits the x-axis, x equals. Now, the quadratic equation looks like this. A, B, and C. So it's negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4 times A times C, all divided by 2 times A. Any questions so far? All right, if you're with me, the next thing I would do is a negative times a negative. Kyle is going to make that a positive 8. A negative 8 times a negative 8 is a positive 64. You only have one negative, so it's going to be a negative 28. When you take 64 and subtract 28, I think it's 36. So 64 minus 28 is 36. And the reason why I like 36 is because it's called a perfect square. So I'm going to finish it up. The square root of 36 is 6. 6 times 6 is 36. You got a plus and a minus. So I'm going to do the plus first. 6 plus 8 is going to be 14. I'm going to say it again. 6 plus 8, so that's 14 divided by 2 is 7. And that checks. Put a little check. That means we got it right. Now I'm going to do the minus. 8 minus 6 is 2. And 2 divided by 2 is 1. And that's what we're doing again today. We're factoring and using the quadratic equation. Is there anybody who doesn't understand how to do number 1? Now this video will be online tonight as well. The next one works the same way. I'm going to do this one and then I'm going to get you started with a few. You're going to turn it in. I won't give you many because I'll give you a little time to relax. So look up here. If you memorize that chart, the only thing it can be is this. The opposite of negative 1 is 1. The opposite of negative 3 is 3. These are your solutions. When you do the quadratic formula, you got to get your A, B, C. You're Michael Jackson. So your A is 1. Your B is negative 4. And your C is 3. A, B, C is first hit. So, Bryce, it's X equals negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4 times A times C, all divided by 2 times A. Any questions so far? All right, if you're with me, a negative times a negative is going to be a positive. Negative 4 times negative 4 is 16 minus 12. This is 4. And the square root of 4 is 2. Now I'm going to do the plus first. 4 plus 2 is 6. Divided by 2 is the 3. 4 minus 2 is 2. And 2 divided by 2 is 1. And that's how we're going to do it. Any questions on what we're doing today? If you have trouble factoring, I want you to ask. If you have trouble using the quadratic equation, I want you to ask. It's not hard. I need you to do it. It's on your test this Friday. On a new sheet of paper, I'm not going to give you that many. We stopped on 15. This is what I want you to put. Put workbook, page 119. Just this side here. And when you're done, turn it in. You know what? As long as you're working quietly, yeah, that's fine. Other than Noah. Yeah, just put it back.
What? Are you being serious?
You know, as long as you're working. Throw it away, please. What? It's not going to kill you. Hey, she's right. Skip 18. Skip 18 and do this one. Start at 21.
So we start
with
one now?
Yeah. Thank you, Priya. Your class thanks you. What?
I don't like the class, but I don't do the class.
Oh, yeah, do you have a Twitter?
No.
I have a Twitter.
Shh.